Today's question: how fast is tube travel? The average driver wastes over $1,000 per year just by sitting in traffic. Clearly, time is money, so it's easy to see why the Hyperloop is so appealing. In Hyperloop Alpha, Elon Musk estimated a top speed of 760 miles per hour. He chose this value because it's lower than the speed of sound, but according to NASA, it's not low enough. They claim that Musk's design would lead to a situation known as choked flow. But the Heimlich maneuver won't help us with this one. To understand choked flow, consider how a car accident on the highway limits traffic flow. In a similar way, the bypass area in a Hyperloop can only let so much air through. If the flow around a capsule becomes choked, any increase in speed will cause a buildup of excess air, resulting in higher drag. But if the pressure inside the tube were low enough, the increase in drag would be trivial, meaning pods could travel faster than the speed of sound. According to a documentary by Extreme Engineering, tube travel could reach speeds of 5,000 miles per hour. But Rand Corporation says 14,000, and ET3's patent says 24,000. So why are these estimates so far apart? The main reason is the chosen distance. If we assume a constant acceleration, the maximum speed depends only on the distance traveled. A reasonable acceleration is half a G, which would cause you to feel about 12% heavier. Darn, right before swimsuit season. So what's stopping us from zooming around the world at 24,000 miles per hour? First of all, let's walk before we run. A 700 mile per hour Hyperloop would be a huge undertaking, and we'll want to make sure it works as planned before we start pushing for higher speeds. Second of all, even if we could reach higher speeds, it might not be safe. Humans don't do well with high accelerations, so emergency stops could be difficult at higher speeds. For now, we'll just have to take things one step at a time and see where it takes us. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Tube Travel.